always changing as it flows through many landscapes. The river has changed billions of years of existence. We will now set forth on a journey back to the distant past. We will travel through time along the life of the Murray and listen to its heartbeat through the ages. We have emerged 30 million years ago. There is no Murray River. It is the Moravian Gulf, as the Southern Ocean stretches far inland. There is no land for the Murray River to exist. It is far beneath its ridges. We are now traveling forwards millions of years through time as the Murray River emerges from the ocean waves. The sea sinks and the land rises. The land is warm and humid. Lush rainforests emerge. The climate becomes hotter still and drier. The tough mallee scrub evolves to dominate. And like much of Australia, the mallee land has evolved so that lightning and fire plays its part. Seeds germinate and bush flowers grow. Amazingly, from the remains of a mallee stump, life returns. The landscape is one of extremes. Regular flooding rejuvenates the soil on which the red gums depend. Red gums over 100 years old begin forming hollows. The hollows provide shelter and breeding habitat for native birds. During times of flood, they provide a safe breeding place for native fish. Seen by the river, yet we are still many tens of thousands of years ago in the past, in an age when huge beasts roamed Australia. The enormous wombat like diprotodon, as tall as a man and the size of a small car. It is a stenurus, a giant short-faced kangaroo, standing over 2 meters in height and up to 3 meters in length. It also longs for a drink of water. Oh. This ambush predator is Megalania, the largest known lizard to ever walk the earth at over 5 meters in length. Twice as long as a Komodo dragon, this giant goanna is to have venomous teeth. One bite would have spelled the end. The disappointed Megalania walks off to prepare another ambush.
From the dreaming comes the law of our existence, our survival. This law must be observed. At the beginning of time, the silent and flat in the darkness, ancestral beings were sleeping below the surface. Time began when the supernatural ancestors broke through the crust of the earth with tumultuous force. And the sun rose out of the ground. Ancestral beings created the Aboriginal people. They created the kangaroo, and the ants, emus, eagles, crows, and cockatoos. They made the natural elements of water, air, and fire. Get the celestial bodies, the sun, the moon, and the stars. The ancestral beings changed the form of the land, creating mountains, water holes, and rivers. There is a dreaming story of Pondi, the Murray. In the dreaming, a huge Pondi burst out of the earth at the source of the Murray River. He traveled along the narrow, trickling stream, digging with his head and swinging with it. Pondi made the rivers deeper and wider. He made all the bends in the billabong. Then a great ancestor speared that mighty fish and all fell to the bottom of the river. The pieces grew into golden perch, the silver bream, and all the other native fish. This is how Pondi the one created the Murray River. All of the ancestral beings were relieved from there. They sank back into the earth and went back to sleep. Their spirits became the rocks, trees, all parts of the landscape. These became sacred places. We observe our dream time law, and this is how we live for thousands of years. And then, the white man came.
There's a story you might not know that happened long ago about the spirit and the fish pioneers of old. They controlled the power of steam and made the Murray part of their dream. So, sit back and listen to my paddle steamer tale unfold. 'Twas in the town of Adelaide, and they just made the declaration about a prize, the mighty fortune in 1851. £2,000 I'll give whoever to navigate the Murray River. It's a highway that could open up this land to everyone. William Randall and his brother named the boat after their mother, Mary Ann, a strange and gamely boat like no one had ever seen. They were farmers, not boat builders, so it was a little out of kilter, but it was on the Murray, a boat powered by steam. The boiler steams the engine, sets the paddle wheels a-spinning. But the bloke who made this boiler, well, there were things he didn't know. It was bulging where it should. Deckhands thought there couldn't be many moments left of life to them. That thing was gonna blow. What I'm just some pioneering spirit would have been the thing to fix it. Wrap it up in chains and wedge it, for it's time for us to go. And they must have felt a shiver when they set off up the river, for their dreams seemed good as they went against the fire. Surprise! It's now a race, as William Randall turns his face to see Captain Francis Cadell and his fancy well-made boat. He's shrewd and calculating, and he knows without mistaking that it takes more than steam and timber to keep your dreams afloat. As Cadell goes passing by in a craft that's twice their size, he flatters those in power with the cooking self-promote. He's named the ship Lady Augusta, after the wife of the governor, and they just captain the passengers upon his paddle boat. Now, William Randall can't be a winner when his rival is having dinner every evening with the governor on Cadell's fancy ship. But he shouted to his team, hoist the sails and boom, with blazing eyes and grating teeth. This unintended race. They steamed on through day and night until Swan Hill came into sight. It seems this was the finish line and Cadell came in first place. The townsfolk, young and old, came out to greet Explorers Bowl to be presented with the winner, Cadell, the canny young captain. There was some self-congratulation, warm applause and adulation. Paddle steamer age upon the river would begin. William Randall came in second, though I'm pretty sure he reckoned there's a better place in history than where he just got shot. So he headed further up the road. There seemed to be no hurry, heading into his flaming fortune on the river.
All along the Murray River, ports sprang up. Glider River Mouth. To Murray Bridge. Manor. Morgan. Through Renmark. To West. And Mildura. Past Robin Bay. And Swan Hill. To Echuca, 1,700 kilometres from the sea. Even as far as Albury-Wodonga, the paddle steamers plied their way, nearly 2,200 kilometres, making the Murray the third most navigable river in the world. There were all types of craft, each with a different purpose. Small milk boats collected dairy produce twice a day along creeks where the larger paddle steamers could not go. Mission boats reached outlying communities without churches. streets were floating shops, supplying everything from food to clothes. Wherever they went, it was a great social occasion for isolated people. Steam engines also meant steam pumps that could draw the water out of the river and onto the fields. The Chaffee brothers founded the town of Mildura by bringing large-scale irrigation techniques to it. Locks and weirs were built across the Murray to regulate the flow of water for farmers. Australia's engineering project, the Snowy Mountain Scheme, is created to provide water and electricity. In the mountains, at the source of the Murray River, snow begins to fall. When the snow melts in spring, the water of the Snowy River is diverted through the mountains and into the Murray River to provide the huge volumes of water needed for irrigation and agricultural purposes. The farming lands on the Murray become the food bowl of the nation. Over a century has passed since the first rice harvested near Swan Hill. Citrus fruits, grapevines for wine, wheat, canola, just some of many of the vital and important crops from this. The Murray has experienced many changes in a short time. The age of the paddle steamers declined as the railways arrived. Followed by the rise of the car. The river has become a place of leisure as well. Fishermen try to catch the mahout. Families relax and glide down the tranquil waters upon houseboats. And water skiers get their thrills behind speeding boats. There is, however, another type of craft that navigates the river. Many of the original paddle steamers are still here, though their roles may have changed. The kayak in Swan Hill. And Chuka, the PS Adelaide, is the oldest wooden pole paddle steamer in the world. The Murray River. Australia's longest river begins high in Stone Mountain. Becomes an alpine stream flowing westward through rolling hills and mountain pastures. It meanders through the Murray as the current takes up the sandstone cliffs and flows through towns and farms until the river fills enormous lakes before emptying into the Southern Ocean a 2,500 kilometers later. The Murray River. Its water is life. And now, we bring you back to this current moment in time, to this same evening. We hope you've felt over the millions of years the heartbeat of the Murray River, a river that even now is changing, flowing towards yet another unknown future.